Thank you, Mr. Speaker and audience at large. I want to propose the motion that states Kenya over reliance on China is killing our industrialization. To begin with, Kenya is the government in the country we are living in. Is the government we are living in. And over reliance is the excessive dependence of something to somebody or something. On is a preposition. China is a country located in Asia. Is a country located on Asia, on the Far East, is a verb. Killing is a murder or destroying something. Our is the first pronoun, first person pronoun in plural. Industrialization is the process, is the social or economic change or that a country undergoes or transforms itself from pre-industrialized to an industrialized state. And here in China, to begin with, China in activity in Kenya, in Africa is exponentially increasing, and Kenya is not an exception. As the Kenyan government takes policy that look east policy, we need to improvise or we need to know how that policy will help us, or they want that situation to be a win-win situation. But we cannot deny the fact that China is our first. Is our first partner in trading, but according to the African Development Bank in 2011, they discovered that USA used to be in that position, but China overtook them in 2009. In my humble request, this has not been the case. It has been a win-lose situation. It has been a win-lose situation in China's favor, and these are my reasons. They have a hand according. Because of the high growth of industries in China, they are having a very high hunger for our industry, our raw materials. But and there are some farms in our industries that deal with many of those raw materials, like minerals and sands. And they will offer that raw material to anybody who is giving them more higher money or bringing them more benefit than the other. But now there are some local farms that also need that raw material. And all of you know what a person does when he's hungry. Of course you don't feel like sharing the food, and that's what they are doing. They don't feel like sharing the raw material, despite the raw material belonging to us, they don't feel like sharing to us. Where will our local farms get raw materials from? They don't have to go to heaven to get it or go to another planet to get it. They have to get from here in Kenya. But how will they get? They don't have the capacity to bring that amount as the Chinese government or industries are offering. And my second point is they are killing our creativity. Despite us having many professors and many people who have PhDs in their pockets, we are not able to innovate anything. Why? Because we are not impractical. We are not doing any practical. We have many procedures of investing nothing, some things that have never been seen in this world. But we cannot even invest the pen we are using now, or the matchstick we are using at home, or the chalk that our teachers are using. So the Chinese overdependence is killing our creativity and innovativity. I wonder if we are planning to decide children by Chinese.
Hi, I'm Basra Mohammed from NEP High School. I'm opposing the motion that says Kenya over reliance on China is killing our industrialization. On to my first point, really, Kenya is really key. On to my first point, education. As we learn primary here, secondary the same, and we need to know more things outside there, which is China. China is it's a developed country, and we study nursing, teaching, lecturers are mainly found in China. On to my second point, a child in China can make watches, laptops within 2 or 3 weeks, but a child in Kenya is just there drinking porridge with low thinking capacity. Thank you.
Hello everyone, I'm Sunan Ali from Salama Girls Secondary.
secondary school. I strongly propose the motion that says Kenya's over-reliance on China is killing our industrialization. Sure you know that? Chinese are producing goods of low cost, which is killing our local farms, as compared to our local farms who are producing goods of high quality. Why? Because they are being affected by the high cost of production and the size of the farms. Hence, selling their goods at a high price. It's the Chinese people who are producing the goods of low cost, which affect the local farms and make them to close their markets. It was discovered, according to the Daily Nation, that in December 2016, that it was found in Kenya, plastic rice, which is being sold at a low price, which has made local farms to close their markets, and the rice that we were producing is not, the consumers are not buying it because of the plastic rice being found, and which is of cheap price. It's which of cheap price.
Sector can be developed by the money that the foreigners give to Kenya. by the desert and tourism sector can be protected from what, from poachers. We really need armed forces, right? To protect our wild animals from those poachers who don't want Kenya to go up, be a developed country like China, and be among top achievers.
Thank you all. I'm Leila Ahmed from Salama Girls Secondary School. I would like to ask my fellow opposers, is it only China that has that have a higher education? And my second question is, why is it that Chinese kids are producing watches and not Kenyans?
My name is Jamila Sarah. I'm from Ifting Girls Secondary School. My question goes to opposers. First is, how can we develop if our own raw material have been taken by China? And what can we do with that money if we have given the whole raw material for the industrial?
I'm Zakaria Abdi from Form 4A Garissa High School. My question goes to NAEP girls. Research carried out by Ipsos Synovate last year said that 89% of Kenyan technology depend on 89% of Kenyan technology industries depend on China. About 7% depend on in Europe. Now, how can we, as a country, protect our industries and we are still relying on China? Thank you.
I am Yusuf Muhammad Tayyip from Al Ibrahim Integrated High School. My question goes to the professors, particularly the first professor. What about the raw materials that our industries cannot utilize well, while some of our materials our country can utilize some materials, which there are some materials which our country cannot utilize well. What about those ones?
Hi, I'm Shukri. I would like to ask the proposers this question. What made Kenya leave their partners USA and go to China and to trade with them? My second question is, you said that Chinese people come to Kenya, take the goods of the farmers, which are of high products. Do they take it by force or the farmers are willing to give them? Thank you.
Hi everyone, I'm Abdullah Abdiala from County High School. My question goes to Umu Salama Girl. Kenya is technologically empowered country and China on the other hand are industrialized country. So don't you think that we should rely on China for technological reasons? Just take a look at the currently underway SGR program where engineers from Kenya were trained in China.
My gratitude and greeting all of you. My name is Amarin Salah. I'm from the institution known as NAEP Girls High School. I'll be giving out points and also answer the question you asked. The first question I'll ask is that, why is it only China making watches and not Kenya? My dear sister, if I can remember what your sister was asking, let me answer your question by telling you that if China is developed, will you blame it for being developed? No, Kenya is not developed, it's developing. That's a process continuing. You get me? So wait until the they reach at the point where China is in at now, right now. The second question was, how can we develop if China took our raw materials? What will we do with the money? If you don't know how to manage money, there's some people who know it and are there in the offices. Don't worry about that. But with the more raw material, you don't know how to make use of it. That's why you're giving out. You don't have the entire industries to work with it. That is why you accept money and give out your raw material. Am I clear? While relying on China. Okay, there's so many ways to rely on China for so many reasons, and we can still develop our countries. Let me tell you something. We have so many things. We have culture, we have our own talent. Let's make use of our talent and bring it. There's waving, basketry, where are those things? Poetry, where are all those stuff? We left it right. And that happened only because you guys were interested in those important things and you are not patriotic with your country. Be patriotic with your country and make your own industries grow. Blame yourself.
us. Can I ask you, most of you are using phones. Look at the phones you are using. Most of it is made in China. Why not made in Kenya? Why? Okay, you keep your answer for yourself. The other thing, they are making us modernized. That's something, you know, like being modern is not wild. You can't just come and say I'm modern. It's something which you have to show and prove. Show that Kenyans are modernized. Chinese are helping you modernize. They are bringing so many stuff into you that you don't even have an idea of. Today, if I take some people of you to the market, there's some phones or some watches you want to know how to operate. What is causing that? Seriously, what's causing that? Being patriotic and stop blaming China and make your own stuff. Thank you very much. Greetings to all of you. My name is Mustafa Mohammed from Salama. I beg to remind my worthy opponent here, say that we are talented. Then why are you depending on Chinese for their creativity and innovation? Even much of this are not invent. And there is one of the audience there who say that we have unutilized raw materials. Why can't you use that unutilized raw materials to develop other parts of yours? There is this thing that says technology. Why can't you? There are many investors like the USA, you can depend on USA and not only China. USA is more developed than China. Why can't you believe that? You can't. And there is this thing. My opponent say that China is doing everything, bringing everything to you. You have to think. No, you cannot only debate on one investor. There are some things that China can do and the US, whereby China cannot do and the US can do. It's not good to depend on one thing. That is like one of my debaters before me said being parasite. And now I think you can answer that thing. I go to my point. Chinese investors in our country is discouraging other investors like USA. This in turn diminishes our diversity of skills and knowledge that we can acquire from USA and us. So, I best dismiss my case. I'm back again. I'm being given 1 minute, but I think I can utilize my 1 minute by objecting and winning up things. Okay, my dear friend was asking me why depend on China and not America. I would have liked to answer you with a question, and my question is why depend on any country while you are independent? And I would like to wind up and say that, okay, me too, I would have liked my country to be counted among the most developed countries in the world, but what? Some people or my government, sorry to blame, are letting me down. So please, let's all wake up and stand for our country. Let's be patriotic. Thank you so much.
I thank my opponent for supporting us, for saying thank you for being, of adding the you audience for being patriotic and loving their country. To that point, you are supporting us. Mainly because we are the ones who are saying that Kenya is a developing country and should rely on itself. Your question was modernization. You said you should copy for these Chinese countries so as to modernize. Why can you depend on yourself to modernize? You have been in school for over 20 years, then you are relying on a small Chinese. You are depending on a small kid, Chinese. In Chinese, you see, small kids, that's what you are wearing. It has been manufactured by small kids, and they are at the age of a baby class in Kenya. So, I ask you, if it is stupid, we can do business with any partner, but we cannot rely on only China and any country. I ask you this, all Kenyans to develop and use the raw materials that we have, beginning the sand that we are working on.
Okay. I think from what we have witnessed, the two teams have really put up a good fight, I would say. But talk on the skill of eloquence. To some, it is coming out very well. To others, it is faltering. Eloquence is a very powerful tool in delivering your message. Of course, it comes up with time. It is still, if you find it faltering, it is still come up. For those who have it, like the apostles, they did. In fact, you can use eloquence to impart your point very well. And of course, they move with the audience.
Okay, thank you very much. Mine will be very short. I think the two presentations are, again, quite good. We have seen some very, very eloquent and articulate presenters. I think continuing that line. And I think for the others, with this kind of practice, this kind of involvement, obviously will also improve. My only comment is on the question of definition, why I admire your eagerness to define the topic. I think when you are defining the topic, I think it will be good if we concentrate on defining the keywords, the content words, rather than defining every single word, including grammatical words like the meaning of and to and all that. I think we can save time by avoiding that and just focusing on the keywords that will help us understand what the topic is about. Otherwise, the level of debate, again, is quite good. Thank you very much.
Yeah, congratulations to the presenters of this motion. I think we have just liked what you are doing right before us, and we just want to comment. There is at least one of the presenters who has helped us see how we can command what we call stage presence. Stage presence. I didn't want to mention the name, but I'm sure all of us can fill in the gap. That was good. Quite confident, standing on the podium, not much movement, and just being able to communicate to your audience. Otherwise, I think we are doing well. Thank you very much.